delivered messages. The guys busted balls and told stories from the old country. Mostly, we just waited. I got to thinking, maybe life in Salieri's crew wasn't gonna get me clipped.
Come on! I got
what
you
did I know?
Finish it off!
You, Tommy?
Come on, there's still a gas in
yeah.
your tank! Get him back!
Boss is waiting for you.
Thanks.
Signora, quell'idiota! Arrenditi! Ah, potrai combattere ancora!
There he is.
Sorry I'm late.
Take a seat. That's collection day, boys. So, Tommy, you'll drive. Paulie and Sam can handle the rest. It'll be routine.
Just a handful of stops today.
Bill at the motel was a little short last month. So make sure he pays us the interest he owes.
No problem, boss.
Don't lay hands on anyone unless there's no other choice. Our clients need to understand that we provide a valuable service. They need to look at you and see Santa Michael. They need to believe you'll protect them.
So let Morella stoop to breaking legs. We're better than that. But the bills still do, and everyone pays up.
We can handle it.
Go see Ralphie about a car.
Okay, boss.
Oh, Vinny said to say he's got something for you, Tom. Head to him first. Probably just wants to tell you some bullshit story about some guy he whacked 20 years ago.
Hey, just the guy. I saw this, and I thought of you. You ever carry a rat?
Shot him at the fair a couple of times.
Right. That don't count. Pointed at the target over there. Good posture, real mean. Now, click, bang. Brain all up the walls. Okay? Now show me a reload. I open the chamber and away you go. All right. Last thing? Needs to be hidden. Stick. Good to go. And when shooting starts, get behind something. And don't shit yourself.
Thanks, Vincenzo. I appreciate it.
Hey, the Frank and the boss is Vincenzo. To you. It's Finny. Hey, when you burn powder out there, need more lead, more guns. Come see Uncle Vin. You know where I'll be.
Look, you guys need to be careful today, okay? I spoke to Biff. He said Morello's still bent since he lost the cars.
What's losing some motion?
You know how to get into one of these, Tommy?
Elbow goes through, reach inside, easy.
And in the afternoon to fix the window back up. Watch. And... Letter.
You're a regular magician, Ralphie.
Come on, Tommy. Show me what you can do. Okay, it's car. You got it. Have a good day, fellas.
First, we got Al. He runs a bakery on Longman Street. You know it?
Yeah, I know it.
Al's late again?
Seems so. That's too bad.
Thank you.
Okay, this is it. Watch what we do today, Tom. When it goes smooth, it's a breeze. When they put up a fight, sometimes you gotta think on your feet.
Sure.
Just follow my lead.
Sam, Polly, how are you?
We're good. How's little Julia?
Ha, not so little now. She's turning into a pain in the ass, just like her grandma.
That's good to hear. Now, real good.
Now, you got any trouble around here? Any punks causing problems?
No, no. Nothing like that.
Good. So you got the money?
I got it waiting in the back room.
Tommy'll get it. You stay here where we can see you.
It's been real slow this month, Sam. I was worried I wouldn't have enough.
Al, I know you'd never hold out on us, but it's good you worry. I mean, how can we protect you and little Julia without pain?
Where's the money?
Perrone, fecha! Voi ci succhiate in sangue!
It's on the table, brown envelope!
Via di qui! Lasciateci in pace!
I got it. We'll see you next month, Al. Let us know if you need anything. Anything at all.
Sure will, Sam. Sure will.
And give our best to your mom, huh?
It was a real pleasure meeting.
Okay, next up we got old Eugene's place. China store up on Tallow.
He's not dead yet?
Almost.
The mission of
his nephew's taking over.
The city's public service broadcaster is to serve you. Start your day.
Guy used to run this next place, Tom. His name's not Eugene. Guy's a Chinaman. But it sounds like Eugene. Well, that's what we called him.
Bobby slammed his head into the counter back in 27, I think.
Yeah, it was hilarious. After that, no problems at all.
And if you look, you can still see the blood. Poor old bastard couldn't scrub it out.
What of the situation in Asia? Who blew it for the Lancers?
We keep some of these guys on our books to remind the Chinatown gangs there in our city, not theirs. But we don't know Eugene's nephew, so he might need reminding too.
Each and every day. The Lost Heaven Courier. With music programming and up-to-the-minute news, this is WLH, Lost Heaven Radio.
This is it.
I'll cover this one, Sam.
You sure?
Sure, I'm sure.
He's doing the store on his own?
Yeah, when Polly's built up a little steam, he needs to let it out on his own. Just gotta let him get on with it. It's his way. You can hear it in his voice. Gotta let him lone wolf from time to time. Keeps him happy. Yeah, Eugene's nephew ain't having much fun right now. When he's going, Polly don't stop. Once we were putting a squeeze on this tailor over in Holbrook, the guy ended up in a wheelchair.
Here he comes.
He's a fast worker.
Drive before the cops show, Tom. Next stop's Bill at the motel. Eugene's nephew's guy's money is ours next week, with some extra besides.
He's doing okay?
He's okay.
How's the shop counter?
Yeah, that's seen some more blood. How much blood? And nothing he can't scrub out. Once he's back on his feet.
Wanna come out with us again, Tom? Get to hear even more about Chinese nephew guys scrubbing their own blood out of shop counters.
Yeah, seems like it's not too hard.
Not hard. Kind of not hard.
I don't know. Comes natural to you guys. Don't see why it can't come natural to me.
So anyone could do this. Me and Polly, we've been working these streets for years. You come in and you think you know it all.
I'm not saying that, Sam.
You've been a day on the job, pal. You haven't seen what we do. You haven't seen how we do it. Sam, I think you ought to... No, Polly. This punk thinks he can walk in here like a big shot. I put greasers like him in the ground.
I think you gotta say you're sorry, Tom.
Sorry, huh? Well, I'd say sorry if I couldn't see the bullshit smile you're trying to hide.
You got him, though, Sam! You got him! I could smell the crap in your pants from here.
Nah, you didn't get me.
When little Tony first came out with us, I had him on his knees before he knew I was yanking his chain.
Yeah, you did better than him anyways.
Jesus, I hate it out of the city.
You hate it most places.
Yeah, but out here it's worse.
How come there's a place so far out of town on our books?
Out of town's the safest place for deals. The safest place for card games. The safest place for most of the things we built.
We're expecting a big bag of money today. The guy owes. If it ain't big, boss will be pissed.
Yeah, this place is a real earner. Oftentimes the places that get you the most dough are the ones most people don't look at twice.
Just recently, the motel's had a new lease of life.
Last stop before Lost Heaven for rum coming up from Cuba.
They drive it this far.
Sure they do. And that's how we can sell it so expensive.
Bill's motel has gotten to be the place where crates get exchanged. Salieri protects it, but he lets the other families use it too.
Even Morello?
To keep the peace? Sure.
Plus, it's far enough away that no one cares.
So long as everyone's making money, no one's gonna rock the boat.
Anyone else starting to miss the sight of streets and sidewalks?
You not one for the great outdoors, Polly?
He's not one for anything. Indoors, outdoors, in the city, out of the city.
I hate it out here. Like when we sit in the field doing some booze handover or something. It's always knee-deep in shit, and most times it's dark and cold as hell.
That's why it's good we got you now, Tom. You can do all the jobs that Polly hates.
But happy to oblige.
Okay, there it is.
Finally! Wait for us here, Tom. We'll be back in a bit.
Okay.
Polly!
Tell Salieri from here on out this place is ours. Capisce? And don't come back, or you'll end up in worse shape than your friends.
Get Sam. They're trying to beat information out of
him. I gotta get you to a doctor.
I can wait. Get Sam out of there.
Okay, just hang on.
Stop it.
There!
Uh. I open you up.
Get a better shot on them.
Get them before they shoot me.
Gotcha now.
Sam, they really went to work on you, buddy.
Christ!
Come on, you'll be all right. You're tough as nails. Oh, shit.
He's got the money, Tom.
Oh, catch the bastard. He's okay. Inside.
Then go get the money!
Gotcha now!
Thank you.
was when I saw the cost, what it meant to be on the inside. I should have took off there and then. But I couldn't go back to being a nobody.
So that's how a regular palooka goes from cabbie to mob enforcer overnight, is it? Just dumb luck?
Didn't feel that way at the time. Me parking on that particular street, taking a break just when Paulie and Sam are coming around the corner, what are the odds? I felt like, I don't know, like someone was watching out for us.
Whatever helps you sleep at night, pal, but it's a lucky break all the same. I mean, one day you're busting your back, doing an honest day's work in a city that's been trying to scrape you off its heels since the day you stepped off the boat, and the next you're stuffing your pockets full of Salieri's dirty money and lording it over the rest of us.
Yeah, it wasn't like that. Back then, Salieri didn't have the run of the city. For every buck Salieri made, Don Morello would turn 10. He paid off cops, politicians, judges, and anyone he couldn't buy, he scared into looking the other way.
He did seem to have the city jumping in its own shadow, I'll give you that.
You hear anything about Joey Crackers?
Yeah, got his name in the Morello file, sure. Boxer, right?
Yeah. That's the guy. Way I hear it. Joey was just driving to the gym one morning. Probably daydreaming about winning a belt or something.
God damn it! Moron! You're driving with your goddamn eyes closed! Look at this! Jesus, Mary, Joseph, Tom Morello, I didn't know it was you.
You know anybody else driving a rare import in this part of town, Joey?
No. Well, then, I'm sorry. I was driving real slow.
You're saying this is my fault?
No, sir. I ain't never been in no accident.
Well, repairs are gonna be expensive.
Oh, you're not gonna need that, sir. The tires are just fine. It's, grill's a little bent up, is all. I mean, I got a cousin.
Someone spun you a tail, pal. You got an informant right there says Morello made a mint every time Crackers went to the mat.
That's true, too. And still, Morello left that poor sap dead in the street. Head all caved in.
That don't square.
Well, maybe the Don knew Joey's career was on the downhill. Well, maybe he was trying to scare some other guy into paying up. Who knows? Don Salieri chalked it up to Morello not being able to think straight when he was mad.
You, have any more run-ins with Morello's crew back then?
Not at first. For a couple of years after I joined up, things were quiet. We got into a few dust-ups with guys trying to muscle in, but elsewise it was just the usual routine. We were running booze, offering protection, me and the boys doing rounds to collect, small time. But I ain't gonna lie. Most days, we was also having a bit of fun.
Tommy, thanks for getting down here so quickly.
Yeah, sure thing, boss. What do you need?
You know, there's a race coming up.
Oh, yeah. Paulie and Sam have some money on the local.
Mikey Dunn.
That's the guy.
He's a good kid, but a bit of a scrapper. Not too smart with his money. A few years ago, Mikey comes to me asking for a loan. He wants to get new tires so he can keep racing junkers out at the quarry. I like fast cars. I figured it'll be a bit of a hobby. Turns out, Mikey's a great investment. The kid can't lose a race if he walks the track. He graduates from the junkers to gouge-jobs, and I start placing a few bets on him here and there. Next thing I know, I've made all my money back and more.
Hey, Sam says he's the guy to beat.
He was. We ran all the competition out of town. But now Ralph says there's a hotshot European entering the race, and he's got a car faster than our boys by a country mile.
How much do we stand to lose?
A truckload. But not just our outfit. A lot of guys from the neighborhood come to me for financial advice. They've all put money down on this kid. It'll be like Black Thursday around here if he loses. Well, for everyone except Morello.
Oh, you think he's from the European?
Oh, I'm certain of it.
You want something to happen to the driver?
Can't find him. Morello's got him holed up somewhere safe. Besides, if he drops out or disappears now, none of our wagers will stand. Everyone will cry foul, say the race is fixed.
What about his car?
That's the ticket, Tommy. Ralph knows a guard at the track. You go down there tonight, you boost the European's car, bring it to one of our mechanics and make a few adjustments, you bring the car back.
Should be no problem, boss.
Sarah, can I get a drink here? Soon as you're ready.
Sure thing.
Your pop letting you out for the race?
You kidding? Feels like we're packing this place up and moving it to the stand.
Hey, buonasera, Tommy. So that's a 5-6.
Hey, Titty Tommy. Big day coming up, right? You seen the race before?
Kind of hard to miss. Celieri isn't going to let Morello break his winning streak, huh?
No, sir. Gotta send him a message. So, tonight, we borrow his guy's motor from the track. My friend Bobby is a guard. For a little dough, he'll show you where it is, then look someplace else while you turn the key.
I like Bobby already.
Sure. Then in there's this other guy, Lucas Bertone. You take the car to him down under the Giuliano Bridge. He'll, you know, tune it a little. Make the race tomorrow more interesting.
Then I take the car straight back, and Bobby can stop looking someplace else.
But you gotta be quick. Bobby comes off shift at 1:30, and then the next guy... he's an ass. Oh, hey, if you need somewhere to keep your motor safe where no one can take them, feel free to use the garage. Carlo finally got around to clearing it out.
Thanks, good to know. Bobby?
Yep. We can take my car through to the garage. It's a ways off.
Any friend of Ralphie's a friend of mine.
If you got the money, sure. Tomorrow morning they start coming. Whole city. They smuggle in hooch. There's fighting. I hate it.
Ah, come on. Name a better place to pick up a dame than this place this weekend.
Don't get me started. Things I've seen.
Okay, this is it. Here she is. 1929 Carrizella C-Series. Best in class. It's a shame to have that.
If they see this on a row, cops are gonna ask questions.
When they catch up, sure. Try to keep it one piece too, huh?
So, I gotta be back from Bertone by 1:30 before the next guy's shift.
Yeah, he's an ass.
I heard.
Tommy Angelo.
Lucas Bertone. Oh, ain't she a thing of beauty?
We don't have much time.
Hey, I'm a fast worker. Sit tight. Hello, you.
Thanks, Lucas. I gotta get back before anyone catches on.
Go easy with her. She's gonna misbehave. Hey, tell Mr. Salieri I'm always available for this kind of work. I do stuff for a lot of people, but I always know where I stand with you guys. Hot cars, getaways, anything for the right price.
Let's just hope Salieri's guy wins tomorrow. For all our sakes.
Okay. Drive careful.
Ah.
cars. Good to go. Drives like a jalopy.
Okay, let's get out of here. Big day tomorrow.
So Sam walks out of the bathroom, and I'm praying he's got a piece on him, because I'm not sure the bartender's going to hand over what he owes. And his two sons, they're inching closer. I can hear them cracking their knuckles. They're both 7 feet tall, built like brick shithouses.
What were you carrying?
My dick.
That's right. This crazy bastard, he waltzes out of the bathroom, just starts pissing all over the joint.
Really? What, he didn't call the cops?
Nah, sometimes you just gotta make them think you're crazy.
Tom, you got a moment?
Oh. Jeffrey.
You've got a bit of a situation.
Is the boss okay?
Oh, yeah, it's nothing like that. Mikey Dunn, our driver. Some of Morello's guys roughed him up pretty good last night. Broke his arm, broke his jaw. Send him to the hospital.
Jesus.
Yeah, tougher locker for Mikey. Anyway, you're going to race for him.
Wait, what? Frank,
Tom,
I don't...
It's a half hour before the starting gun goes off, so this is not a discussion. But Don wants to win. But more importantly, he wants Morello to lose. And you are our best wheelman. Otherwise, I'd be talking to someone else.
Yeah. Okay, Frank.
Good. Rafi has the car gassed and ready. Get to the track right away.
From Europe, we got the hotshot favorite, Martin Lichtenberg, taking some time out of the International Series to compete with us today. Got some news from the grid here. Lost Heaven local favorite Mikey Dunn is out. Replacing him is Tommy Angelo. Well, I'm sure you'll all join me in wishing him good luck. They're lined up on the grid. They're ready to start. They're off. Lichtenberg's in trouble. There's something up with his car. Lichtenberg is out. The favorite is out. Who's going to survive the loss?
Son of a bitch! Oh, shit!
They're bunching up, and I see some collisions. Some of these drivers need to be. There's more than paperwork getting done today. Some rough racing out there. Hopefully nothing serious. Lichtenberg's exit really has blown this race out wide. They all smell victory.
You're kidding me!
Angelo is still out in front. Can he hold on? What a race today, folks! The driving's been incredible! Are these the final podium places, or is it someone else's time to shine? The race leaders roar into the second lap. Look at Mikey Dunn. This guy is a fine replacement.
Amateur! Son of a bitch!
It's a big race today, folks. Some drivers really starting to stretch out ahead now.
Oh, shit!
Angelo, all still in the mix, with Guy still left to go.
Him!
Angelo there, back in the lead position. Can he hold on? Tommy Angelo's in first, but will he stay there? Anderson and Garcia are in second and third, waiting for a mistake from Angelo. The leading drivers are on the final lap. Not long till it's all over, folks. Who's going to catch the leading driver, Tommy Angelo?
Yeah, no, Court! The son of a bitch!
Aggressive driving from Angelo. With Lichtenberg no longer a contender, the front three are jostling for position.
Jesus!
Up close and personal with the pack leaders, this race is far from over.
You're kidding me!
It's a tight pack as they fight for first. Newcomer Tommy Angelo is still out in front.
Tommy, there's our winner.
Hey, Tom, just want to thank you for stepping in like you did. I had 6 months rent riding on that race. I'd be homeless now if not for you.
I just did what the Don asked, Lucas.
Well, you gotta let me find a way to repay you. Stop by my garage when you get a chance. I might have a line on something that'll turn a buck for you.
Sure, thanks.
I knew you wouldn't let us down, Tom. You made us all a lot of money today. And Morello's gonna be picking up pennies off the sidewalk for weeks.
Hey, what about the European?
He's probably wearing cement boots by now, the poor bastard. Here. You earned every dollar of this. Take your girl out somewhere nice.
Thanks, boss.
What's up, boys?
You got a girl, right? I don't want you blowing all that on booze and whores.
Something, huh? Cheers.
Nah, but, maybe I'll buy my mom a new coat.
Good boy. Go get yourself a drink.
Congratulations, big hero.
Nah, just got lucky's off.
Well, I had my money on the other guys, so drinks are on you.
Oh.
There. Now you're ready for the pictures.
Thanks.
And hey, when you're done celebrating, you might want to go find your buddy, Polly. He's so drunk, he's gonna get hit by a parked car.
Yeah, okay. I'll get him home safe.
Polly and the rest of your pals have drunk through half my bar already. You found him yet?
That's all for another year, folks. Track will be open until 6. Please leave when
you remember made that look easy to Tommy. When they started racing here 20 years ago, most guys didn't even make the finish.
Ah, magic's in the motor, Ralph. I just showed him where to go. Hey, you seen Paulie?
Oh, no. He said he was hungry or something.
Okay. You enjoy yourself.
That win just put my daughter through another year at school, Tom.
Great race, champ. Anything for the Coletti's.
Well, enjoy the moment. But deal with Paulie before he embarrasses himself and the family. I will not let the boss's day end sourly.
You don't have to worry, Frank. I'll find him.
I've been asked by the LHPD to remind all racegoers that the sale and consumption of alcohol is strictly prohibited. An arrest will be made. Thank you.
Great race, champ.
Hey! Last time I saw you drive like that, Tom, I had a gun to your head.
You saying there wasn't one today?
When our side of town is drowning in dough, that means you're safe. Hey, you seen Paulie? Guy's soused. Came through walking sideways.
This your first time at the track?
Last year I heard the motors for my apartment, but that's as close as I've gotten before.
Plus that's to try to clear.
How'd you drive after the tuna?
Tried to go sidelong at a 5-brick walls, but we made it. You seen Paulie any place?
Came by 5 minutes ago, maybe. Looked like he had a smell from the barrel.
Sounds about right. Thanks, Lucas.
Great run, Tommy!
Substances. Let's not make it like last year, folks.
These things get faster every year.
Faster, yes. Entertaining. No. Some years, it feels like a...
Oh, thank Christ you're here. If your friend keeps this up, the other guy's gonna send the cops over.
Yeah, I think Paulie's big day at the track's over.
Cow says moo, and the chicken says quack. What does the bird say?
I don't know, but the security guy back there says you gotta go home.
Guy's an asshole. You should show some respect!
Well, that's true, but I'm saying you gotta go home, too, before you resurface the pit lane.
Well, okay, then. I guess.
Let's go, Jim.
Tommy, with the driving. I was right. I was right when I found you. You know what I said?
What did you say, Paulie?
I said this guy can drive, Don Salieri. This is a guy who can drive.
And here we are.
Here we are. Right here. That's where we are. You put me to shame, Tom. Look at you. Now you're even a some kind of race car driver.
We all got our...
Doing real good since you joined the family, but you know you got it easy, right? Me and Sam, we keep the real stuff from you.
That right, huh?
You don't know what it's like. You get the call to see the Don in your mind's race. Done some bad shit, Tom.
All in this together. I do what the Don asks when he asks. Just like you.
You're like me, you can't just shut it down. Blank it out like Sam does. Go home to... whoever the hell he goes home to.
Bali, you're drunk. You're gonna have to clam up for your own sakes.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. Tom, I wanna go with the lady.
I'm not helping you with that today.
Take me to the ladies! Take me to the Blue Tropics.
I don't know. I gotta take you home.
The bridge. Take the bridge over to the island. Take me to the ladies. Take me to those sweet patooties.
I don't know. Taking you home seems more classy.
Oh, now we're talking. Oh, boy. You should see these dames, Tom. Woo-hoo-hoo.
I'll leave it to you to swim with the barracudas, Bali.
Home? Bring me home. Maybe that's, a good idea. Okay, I'm gonna.
Sweet dreams, tough guy.
I'm gonna. I don't feel so good.
That's the call, Tom. You want anything else?
Nah, I'm heading home.
Hey, Tom, before you go, I ask maybe a small favor.
Sure, Luigi, what do you need?
Welcome my daughter home.
Sarah? The way I hear it, she doesn't need any kind of escort.
she's a tough. This is a pack of boys near her place. The punks, you know, cattivi ragazzi. They talk blue, make advances. Sarah, she's gonna speak the mind. But maybe she says something they don't like. Things get ugly. But if you working at home, this will remind that these punks, she's the Don's a goddaughter.
No problem, Luigi. I'd be honored.
Benny. Sarah, the time is to close.
What's this then?
Tom's gonna take you.
All right.
Hey, I just work here.
Make sure nobody bother you.
Fine. If it'll make you feel better, Pop.
Hey.
I'll see you tomorrow. Let me get my coat.
I'll wait for you outside. You okay?
I don't need anyone walking me home.
Hey, we were talking about meeting up tonight anyway.
I guess.
And you can quit worrying about what he's gonna think.
Not the point, Tom. He treats me like a kid sometimes.
Hey, I get it. He's protective. He's seen things.
We've all seen things.
You know, we gotta talk about you stealing food.
Hey, I cook it, so I get to say where it goes.
Bali won't thank you.
Well, maybe tomorrow's finally gonna be the day he fixes his own breakfast. Could you knock on the door? Only got so many hands here.
Sarah! That for me?
Yeah, though it's not as much as last time.
It's enough. Nonna thinks you're an angel.
The Don hates seeing food go to waste.
And this? This has got to be Tammy. Sarah told us all about you.
Isn't that right?
You're a famous race driver, Tom. Everyone talks about you.
Yeah, she's right. They do.
Well, anyways, don't let the cold in, Juliet. I'll see you at church.
All right. Have a great evening.
Night.
Buena noche, Tommy.
It's nice you do that.
That? Well, a lot of hungry people on this block.
Yeah. Well, it's a good night for a walk anyway.
Don't get yourself killed on my account, Tom.
I try to avoid it.
That's all you got? You spend all this time with a lady killer like Sam Trapani, and the best line you got is, good night for a walk anyways?
Well, it is, ain't it?
Yeah, I guess so.
Flowers for the lady, signore?
Nah, we're good.
Now I don't get flowers?
When you let me take you on a real date and not some walk home for Luigi, then you get the flowers.
Yeah, that could happen. If Pop's not gonna stop me seeing one of yous. I think he knows anyway.
Luigi? Nah.
These guys have been creeps to me for weeks. But I didn't tell you as I know what you like. I mentioned it to Dad this one time, and all of a sudden he gets you to be my knight in shining armor. So yeah, he knows.
Huh. Well, like I say, means there's no problem with me.
If he did, you wouldn't last long. I know what happened to all the other guys I dated. I helped hide the bodies.
So now we are.
I've been trying to keep you safe, Tommy Angelo, all this time.
Let's go someplace. Tomorrow night, maybe. The pictures, maybe. You can get your flowers.
That'd be good.
Oh! Hey there, darling! Are you stepping out on us?
Piss off.
Don't cast the kitten, doll face. We'll let your boyfriend watch. What do you say?
We going to have trouble here.
Trouble started back when you tried to steal our girl, Chief.
You saps aren't careful. You'll end up in wooden overcoats. Last chance to walk away.
We ain't frails. We know who you work for.
Salieri might have been the big six when he was younger, but he's all washed up now. It's only a matter of time before Morello punches his ticket.
I don't need Salieri. Or anyone else. Not for this.
Well, then let's see what you got, cake eater.
Where are you going here, sweet cheek?
Get away from me!
Looks like you was wasted on the greaser. Hey!
Get away!
Nah. Nah, I won't. Hey.
Tommy!
My turn now.
Hope you're better than your friend. That's what I got, you son of a bitch.
You got a good right hook, I'll give you that. You're bleeding. Come up to my place, I'll take a look. Well, you gonna come in and take a load off, or what?
I'm wondering when you'd invite me up.
The bank's closed, Slugger. I'm just gonna patch you up, is all. Now go sit down on the couch, roll up your sleeve. I'm getting my sewing kit. Doesn't look too bad. You need something for the pain?
No, I'm fine.
You don't have to do that.
What?
I can see it fucking hurts, Tom. You want to pretend it, don't go ask Polly to staple you up.
What do you get?
Compliments of the Don. Take another. All right. You gonna grin and bear this?
Yeah, I'll be okay.
Good. Because I don't need the little old lady next door complaining to the super about all the racket.
Just be quick about it, will ya?
Oh, it's gonna take as long as it takes. The sloppier the stitch, the uglier the scar.
They're right. You stitched up a lot of fellas.
Just my father. Ma would really go after Luigi sometimes. He got pretty good at ducking dinner plates. So one day she stabbed him with her knitting needle. Right through the hand.
What for?
'Cause. She was an ugly, jealous drunk. There. Not my best work, but it'll hold.
The scar'll be something to remember you by, if nothing else.
You're staying over. Can't have you stumbling through the neighborhood pie-eyed. Not when them hoods are out looking for you anyways.
Yeah, okay. You got an extra blanket or something?
No. And the heat's out.
Myself, though.
This can't stand.
Sarah's okay, boss. I took care of it.
She started working here before she could see over the bar. I don't have a daughter of my own, Tom. I'd do anything for Luigi's little girl.
So would I. We all would.
That's right, boss. Anything for Luigi and Sarah.
Do those bastards think this is fucking Luna Park or something? I'll rip them apart with my own hands.
Our business is protection. But who's gonna pay up when they learn we can't even protect one of our own as she walks home from work?
So what do you want us to do?
Teach these boys a lesson. Break every bone in their bodies, put them in wheelchairs, bust their faces up so bad even their mothers can't look at them without screaming.
We know where they're holed up.
My friend on the force says we should start looking into Chinatown.
Then Big Biff will know something. Tommy, go to Vinny, get us some gear.
Meet me at Biff's place.
Yeah, okay.
Leave these punks laying in the street. I want everyone to know we do not allow mad dogs to run wild in our neighborhood.
You got it, boss.
Some of these sons of bitches could still be on our turf.
I'll check the neighborhood. Make sure they're gone while you see Biff. Good hunting.
Yeah, same. Okay, so when you're done with Vinny, come find me in Chinatown.
Sure.
Let's go bust some heads. Punks showing disrespect.